Now, this really happened, and except for my faulty memory, what I remember is absolutely true. Have you ever been frog gigging? Now, down on Walker's Bend, my grandfather kept a pond, and he never bush hogged too close to it. And now when the willow and the pine trees fell over, he didn't clean it out. It made a splendid froggy, snaky mess. And it was a great place for bullfrogs and a great place for water moccasins. Now, you know, the water moccasins loved the bullfrogs, and the bullfrogs loved mosquitoes, and snakes ate the bullfrogs, and the bullfrogs ate the mosquitoes, and it's what scientists call an ecosystem. Everything existed to help one another. Oh, kinda. Remember like when you were in high school or at work? During the mating season, that pond was a regular karaoke bar. Those old bullfrogs would sing their hearts out to their lady loves, dodging snakes and looking for dates and mates. It was a regular e-harmony. You know, that is really the best time to go frog gigging because the bullfrogs are distracted. Now, what it is, frog gigging, it's a male bonding experience. You and a friend wade out into unknown territory, and it's dark and can't see where you're going or what you're doing, and all kinds of dangerous night critters are bumping and slithering, scaring yourself silly. But it's fun. Like I said, it's really a male bonding experience. Frog gigging equipment is pretty simple. All you need is a frog gigger, looks like a miniature pitchfork, a bright flashlight, duct tape to the frog gigger. I always carried a shiny chrome 6-battery Rayovac. That's to blind them. And a 5-gallon plastic bucket, stretch an old tractor inner tube across the top of it with a slit in it. That's to keep the frogs from jumping out. Well, now I remember near midnight on a Friday, my cousin Pete and I were carefefully making our way through the kudzu and undergrowth down to the pond. Pete is deathly afraid of snakes. He had his snake-proof waders pulled clear up to his eyeballs. I looked behind me and I couldn't see a thing, but I could hear Pete hollering, "Help! Help! Help!" Well, I swung my light around and there he was, hung up like a June bug in a spider web. All I could see was his eyes shining between two big old kudzu leaves. And did I mention he's deathly afraid of snakes? I took one look at him, and I knew I couldn't pull him out by myself. And I said, "Hold on, I'll go get the tractor." And I got my granddaddy's 1953 Ford Golden Jubilee Edition. And I threw a lead rope into Pete and pushed in the clutch, put the tractor in the granny gear, and began pulling. He wouldn't budge. Well, the only thing I could think of was Hal. Go get Hal. He crop dusted my granddaddy's farm with a helicopter. You couldn't use a plane back in those hills and hollers, and you couldn't just use any helicopter either. He had a little Robinson R-22 that you could turn it on a dime. And when I stepped up on his front porch, and it was well after midnight, the old hound started barking, and the porch light came on, and a gun barrel stuck out the screen door. Now, Hal had on his overalls and had one gallus slung over his bare shoulder, and the other was just a-flopping. And I was standing under a naked 100-watt light bulb with a cork-topped brown jug in my hand. Hal asked what I wanted, and he was reluctant at first to get out being night and all. But he was up to a challenge, and especially when he eyed that gallon of my Uncle Charnel's best. I told him that Pete was hung up in kudzu down at the frog gigging pond. And he said, "I'll be right there." And in a little bit, we heard the whoop, 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 whoop. And he spotted my light that I'd sprung up in the air, and he shined his spotlight down on Pete, and he lowered a tow line. Well, Pete grabbed the rope, and Hal gunned that helicopter and yanked him right up out of that kudzu 100 feet up in the air. And as Pete flew by me, he was a-hollering and dancing around, "There's a snake in my pants! There's a snake in my pants!" And that little helicopter dipped left, and then it dipped right, and Hal hollered, "Stop it! You're going to make us crash!" Did I mention Pete's deathly afraid of snakes? Hal wobbled over the pond, and I don't know if it was Pete's dancing or Uncle Charnel's joy juice that was causing the wobbling. He hit the release button, and Pete and 100 foot of rope and that snake hit the water. Kawoosh! Bubbles gurgled up, and there was an eerie silence. Now, no one would confuse Pete with Saint Peter. But all at once, Pete was propelled right out of that pond. He was a-gurgling and a-praying. You might think I'm exaggerating, and I know, it was dark and all down there. He was walking right on top. Pete had had a life-changing experience. That next Sunday, when the preacher asked him if he wanted to be baptized, Pete said, No, thank you, Reverend. I've already been to the water. You might say, it was a holy epiphany.